In this video, I'll be addressing a couple of quick questions about using RDFLib in Python along with SPARQL. Here's the first quick question. For those of you that work in RDFLib, have you used the count function? If so, how do you print your results? I know this is basic, yet I need some guidance. Thanks. So what I'm going to do here is I will first open up a little graph. This is the NobelPrize.org data set that I got from its SPARQL endpoint. I did a few transformations on it just in order to include the vocabulary in the set of triples. So it's enriched with the vocabulary, not just the data. So here I'm using the RDFLib Python library. I'm using the gzip package from the standard library, creating an RDFLib graph. I'm opening this gzipped ntriples file, and I am parsing that into the graph. Now, getting to the count function. Here, given the RDFLib graph, I am going to issue a SPARQL query against it and iterate over each row of the result. So here we have SPARQL where I have the Nobel prefix for the Nobel Prize terms and the DBpedia ontology, which is part of the Nobel Prize dataset. Here I have my select statement where I issue a count SPARQL function. I'm going to count all of the variables bound as laureate, all the instances bound to the laureate variable, and select that count as n laureates. Also institution country and country of birth, where a laureate is a Nobel laureate. A laureate has a DBpedia ontology birthplace of what I'm calling birth country, where that in turn is a DBpedia ontology country. Also, the laureate should have a DBpedia ontology affiliation of some, what I'm calling an institution, where that institution in turn has a DBpedia ontology country associated with it, which I'll call institution country. And I'm issuing a SPARQL filter for not the same term, where the country of birth and the URI for the country of birth and the URI for the country of the institution associated with the laureate award are not the same country. So I'm trying to find a count of laureates where their country of affiliation of their institution is not the same as their country of birth. So you might refer to these as immigrant laureates. So in order to do the count, I'm doing group by institution country and birth country. So unique pairs of those, order by descending number of laureates in limit 5. And here I can just print the SPARQL results. And so this is one way to just print these. Now this uses the RDFLib internal format. You can see these Python data structures. The count is an RDF literal with that string representation, and the data type is an XML schema data type integer, and then we have a Nobel Prize country USA as the institution country and the country of birth being Germany here for this row. So this is a bit busy. So one thing we can do to clean this up in terms of printing is use, for example, RDFLib namespace facilities. Here I have creating a Nobel namespace and a DBpedia ontology namespace. And to the graph that's holding our triples, the namespace manager, I'm binding this prefix Nobel to this namespace DBO, the DBpedia ontology, and the country prefix to this namespace resource country, so that we can get a more pretty printing for these outputs. So I'm reconstructing this query here. I'm using the RDFLib SPARQL prepare query plugin just in order to prepare the query so that I can issue it multiple times. Oh, I haven't executed this cell yet. So when I execute that cell, then I can prepare the query. And I'm just using some F-string stuff in order to insert those namespaces in there so I don't have to retype them as I did before. This is another thing I like to do that's good for convenience. The only issue with using F-strings is when you actually want a curly brace, you need to have two curly braces for the select clause, but that's about it. The other convenience function is this pretty print terms function where I use the graph namespace manager in order to actually print out the terms. So now when I issue the same query, we get something that looks a little nicer. So the count of laureates is 21 who were born in Germany, but their institution affiliation for their prize is in the USA, and so on and so forth. Okay, so that's how you can print from the result of a count SPARQL function query or really anything else. So I just wanted to demonstrate the use of count in preparing a query and in printing out the terms. Okay, another RDFLib question. Is there a way to take SPARQL results and push them to a CSV? I've looked through documentation, it looks possible, but I'm still a bit puzzled. My colleagues want Excel sheets, I know. So yes, one quick way of doing this is issuing the same query, prepared query, SPARQL query on the graph as before, and that gives a query result, which you can then serialize directly to a destination in a given format. So here we're doing a results.csv file in the local directory, given the format CSV. So once we issue that, I'm escaping out to my bash shell so I can just view it here. And you can see the header row and laureates, I country, B country, 21, the URI for USA, the URI for Germany. You can see here in this native format, we don't preserve the fact that this is an integer. It just uses string serialization. That's all you can really have in a CSV. So it might be nice to do this sort of thing, or if you just have the type explicit in the string serialization in the CSV. Alternatively, if you have a header row, then you could just know that, say, the RDFS range of and laureates is an XSD integer, and call it a day. Otherwise, if you want something a bit more custom, you can go into native Python. For example, this block of code will produce the same result as above. And here what we're doing is we're importing the CSV module in the standard library. We're binding to that result of the SPARQL query. I'm opening a CSV file. I'm using the dictionary writer class in the CSV module. I'm using the variables of the SPARQL result to be my field names over here. And then for each of the result findings, and I'm writing that as a header of the CSV, then for each of the result findings of a field name to value, in this case, I'm just taking the string representation of the RDFLib object of each of these and writing a row, and that's how I reproduce that. I could do something more fancy in order to express the type information of the literals, but here I just reproduce that here. Okay, I hope this was helpful to learn a bit more about the use of RDFLib and getting results out and working with SPARQL. Thank you.